Welcome to my channel. Today we are going to solve one digital Butterworth filter design using bilinear transformation. Okay, so already the analog Butterworth filter problem we solved. Okay, so nearly three problem we solved in analog. Okay, so now similarly the impulse invariant method we solved four problems. So now we are going to see the bilinear transformation problem. Okay, so already one bilinear transformation problem solved if directly the h of s is given. Okay, so that is a university question, May 2018 and May 2013 question. Okay, so already I posted in the previous video. If you want to learn that video, I will give link in the description box. You can refer it. Okay, so now we are going to see the problem. This is the complete 15 mark question or 13 mark question. So you see the question, design a digital Butterworth filter, okay, with the following specification, modulus of h of e power j omega lies between 0.7071 whenever the frequency omega between 0 to 0.55. Then modulus of h of e power j omega is less than or equal to 0.2 whenever the frequency from 0.75 to 0.5. Determine the system function h of z for Butterworth using bilinear transformation. Okay, so here we are going to design digital Butterworth filter. Okay, so already you know in IER filter design there is no straight procedure in order to design the digital IER. First we have to design the corresponding analog IER, then we have to convert using impulse invariant method or bilinear transformation or matched Z transform method. Okay, so here we are going to use the method bilinear transformation. So it's a very important university question, May 2017 question. Okay, so first one, we are going to write the given data. Okay, so you know the frequency response for our low pass filter. Okay, so this is the digital frequency omega versus h of e power j omega. So already you know the two frequency, this omega, okay, this w omega, it is said to be the digital frequency. Okay, in order to represent digital frequency, we are using this omega. This ohm omega, it is used to mention the analog frequency. Okay, so here the digital frequency value is given. Okay, digital frequency response frequency is given. So if this is the low pass filter frequency response, so this is the maximum value 1, then this is 0.707, okay, 0.707. So in this 0.707, we can get, this is the passband frequency, not this W omega. Okay, since here all frequency is given in digital frequency, omega P, okay, 0.707, and this is 0.2. In 0.2, we are getting the frequency omega s. Okay, so this is our filter frequency response. So the 0.707 from the frequency omega between 0 to 0.55. Okay, this is 0. So this omega p is 0.55. Okay, so from the frequency 0 to pi by 2, 0.55 means pi by 2, it is a pass band. Okay. Then this omega s is 0.75 pi. Okay, omega s stop band frequency is 0.755 to pi. The magnitude is reduced to 0.2. Okay, that is the thing. And already know this. What is this 0.707? That is the magnitude response at a frequency omega equal to omega p. It is nothing but 1 by square root of 1 plus epsilon squared. Okay, already we discussed in the design of analog Butterworth filter. Okay, the same thing. So this 0.2 is nothing but 1 by square root of 1 plus lambda squared. So here 1 by square root of 1 plus epsilon squared is given. 1 by square root of 1 plus lambda squared is given. And the digital frequency omega p omega s is given. Okay, so you just note down the thing. Okay, this is the first thing. So this 0.707 is nothing but 1 by square root of 1 plus epsilon squared. Okay, this 0.2 is nothing but 1 by square root of 1 plus lambda squared. and this 0.5 pi, it is a passband frequency. Okay, digital passband frequency. This 0.75 pi is the stop band frequency omega s. Okay, so this four data given. Okay, so these are all the four data given. So using this data, we are going to design the digital Butterworth filter in bilinear transformation method. Okay, so in bilinear transformation, what is the procedure? Okay, so already we discussed the procedure in the previous video. Okay, so what is the first step? First step, we have to find the analog pre-warping frequency. So you see the step. If you want to learn that steps to design, I will give link in the description box. So you can refer it. So the first step is to we have to find pre-warping analog frequency from the digital frequency. We have to find the analog frequency, passband analog frequency, and stopband analog frequency using this formula. Okay. Then using the given specification, we have to find H of S. Okay. Then in H of S equation, you just replace instead of S, we have to substitute. This means we can get H of S. This is the steps to be followed in order to design the digital IR filter. Okay, so the first step, so from the given specification, we have to find pre-warping analog frequency. Okay, so before that, we have to find out the epsilon value and the lambda value from this two thing. Okay, already you know how to derive it. So here 1 by square root of 1 plus epsilon squared is given as 0.707. What is 0.707? It is a 1 by root 2. Okay, so from that, we have to find epsilon. So that's why first I am taking square on both sides. Then I am taking reciprocal. So we can get 1 plus epsilon squared is equal to 2. Okay, so from that epsilon equal to 1. Okay, we calculated. Similarly, 1 by square root of 1 plus lambda squared is equal to 0.2. Similarly, you do first you take square on both sides. So 1 by 1 plus lambda squared is equal to 0.2 squared. Then from that you take reciprocal. So 1 plus lambda squared is equal to 1 by 0.04, it is 25. Then from that lambda squared is equal to 25 minus 1, 24. Then you take square root. So lambda equal to 4.8989. Okay, so already we discussed this problem in Chebyshev filter and Butterworth filter, analog filter design in previously. Okay, the same step you follow. Epsilon value we calculated as 1. Lambda value we calculated as 4.8989. Okay, then the first step is to we have to find the pre-warping analog frequency. So the passband analog frequency omega p. Okay, this ohm omega indicates analog frequency. This w omega indicates digital frequency. So omega p equal to, what is the formula? 2 by t turn omega p by 2. Okay, so here t, what is the sampling time is given? Sampling time is not given. So you just assume t equal to 1 second. Okay, so 2 by 1 turn off. What is omega p? What is the digital passband frequency? 0.5 pi. Okay, so you substitute here. So turn off 0.5 pi divided by 2. So using CALCI, you just calculate. It is at 2 radian per second. Similarly, the stopband analog frequency, omega s is equal to 2 by t turn omega s by 2. So 2 by 1 turn off. What is the given digital frequency? 0.75 pi divided by 2. So the answer is 4.828. Okay, so now we are having the four data, epsilon, lambda, omega p, omega s. Okay, then next one, the next step is to we have to design the analog Butterworth filter first. Okay, so we have to follow the Butterworth filter design procedure. So you just recall, so already we solved the three problems, analog Butterworth filter design. Okay, so if you want to learn that videos means, I will give link in the description box, you go and watch. Okay, then only this problem is very easy. Okay, so in the design of analog Butterworth filter, what is the first step? First step, we have to find the order of the filter. Okay, so what is the order formula? N is greater than or equal to log of lambda by epsilon divided by log of omega s by omega p. This is the order of the Butterworth filter. Okay, so you substitute lambda value, epsilon value, omega s, omega p as it is. So log of, what is lambda? Lambda is 4.8989 divided by epsilon is 1. Okay, divided by log of omega s is 4.828, omega p is 2. Okay, so you just solve. So the answer is 1.803. So n is calculated. Then the next step is to we have to round off this n value to the next highest integer. So 1.803, it is rounded off to n equal to 2. Okay, so we rounded off. So our given specification is a second order filter we are going to design. Okay, n equal to 2. And so from the table, okay, so I given one Butterworth normalized Butterworth filter denominator polynomial table already I given. Okay, so in that Butterworth filter design problem, it is there. So from the table, you know, for n equal to 2, the transfer function of normalized Butterworth filter, it is a standard thing. H of s equal to 1 by s squared plus root 2 s plus 1. Okay, this is the normalized second order Butterworth filter. Okay, so we have to take that. Then next one, next step is to we have to find out the cutoff frequency using the formula. Cutoff frequency omega c equal to omega p by 10 to the power 0.1 alpha p minus 1 to the power 1 by 2n. Okay, so here, so which is equal to omega p. So here we have to substitute the omega p value, and here you see you know that 10 to the power square root of 0.1 alpha p minus 1 to the power 1 by 2. Okay, that is nothing but epsilon. So here in our problem, alpha p is not at all given, but epsilon you know. Okay, so what's the value of epsilon? The epsilon is 1. Okay, so we derived epsilon is equal to 1. So omega p by epsilon to the power 1 by n. So omega p is 2 divided by 1 to the power 1 by 2. So the answer is 2 radians per second. So cutoff frequency we calculated. Okay. Then after calculating cutoff frequency, we are having normalized second order Butterworth filter transfer function. So that normalized Butterworth transfer function, we have to convert into our desired cutoff frequency transfer function. Okay. So for that, we have to substitute s equal to, in the place of s, we have to substitute s divided by omega c. Okay, our cutoff frequency we have to substitute. So what is omega c here? 2. So you just replace s by s divided by 2 in our normalized Butterworth filter equation in order to change it to our Butterworth filter. Okay, normalized Butterworth filter means the Butterworth filter having the cutoff frequency equal to 1 radians. Okay, but from the given specification, what is the cutoff frequency? It's a 2 radian. So in order to convert this normalized Butterworth filter into our desired cutoff frequency filter, you just replace s by s divided by omega c. Okay, so therefore the h of s equal to 1 by instead of s by 2 the whole squared plus root 2 into s by 2 plus 1. Okay, so you solve this, we can get the answer is 4 by s squared plus 2.828 s plus 4. Okay, so up to this, the analog transfer function we designed. Okay, so what is the next method? We have to convert this analog transfer function into digital Butterworth filter using bilinear transformation. So already you know the method in bilinear transformation. In bilinear transformation, the digital transfer function H of Z is obtained by substituting S equal to 2 by T 1 minus Z inverse by 1 plus Z inverse in H of S equation. Okay, so in this H of S equation, instead of S, we have to put 2 by T, 1 minus Z inverse by 1 plus Z inverse means we can get H of Z. Okay, so you see, so H of Z is equal to H of S at S equal to 2 by T. Here T is not given. We are assuming T equal to 1 second. So 2 into 1 by Z inverse by 1 plus Z inverse. Okay, so in the H of S equation, you just substitute. So instead of this S squared S, you just substitute. Okay, then you take LCM. Okay, throughout the equation, in denominator, you take LCM. So here, 4 into 1 minus Z inverse the whole squared plus, if you are multiplying this, 5.656 into 1 minus Z inverse into 1 plus Z inverse plus 4 into 1 plus Z inverse the whole squared, then divided by 1 plus Z inverse the whole squared will come, that we will give it to numerator. Okay, so after that, you expand it throughout the equation. So after cancelling, we can get the transfer function h of z is equal to 0.2929 1 plus z inverse the whole squared by 1 plus 0.176 z power minus 2. So this is the transfer function of our digital Butterworth second order filter for the given specification. Okay, so that's all. This is the step. So if you are solving the same problem in impulse invariant method, means it will take so many steps, but bilinear transformation, it is easy to solve. Simply in H of S equation, you just replace S with this one. Okay, that's all. Okay, so just recall the problem. The first one, from the given specification, we have to find out epsilon and lambda. Okay, first one, epsilon and lambda, we have to find out. Then pre-warping analog frequency, we have to find out. It's a step number one. Then from the given specification, we have to find out order of the filter n. Then we have to round off the n value to the next highest integer. Then we have to write for the corresponding n value from the Butterworth table, we have to take normalized Butterworth filter transfer function. The next step is to, we have to find the, we have to calculate the cutoff frequency using the formula. Then in normalized Butterworth filter equation, you just replace S by S divided by omega C. Okay, this is our analog Butterworth filter, filter transfer function for the given specification. Then using bilinear transformation method, in the place of S, use just replace with this value, means we can get the digital transfer function. This is the method in order to design bilinear transformation. Okay, so thanks for watching my channel. And please subscribe my channel for more videos. It's a university question. It's a May 2017 question. Okay, digital Butterworth filter design. Sometime analog Butterworth filter design, they may ask. Most of the time, digital Butterworth or digital Chebyshev filter problem, it will come in university question. Okay, so based on this, you just solve this problem. Okay, so thanks for watching my channel, and please subscribe, and please share this video to your friends also. Okay, so if you want to learn all lecture videos related with this subject, digital signal processing, in my channel, in the name of discrete time signal processing and digital signal processing, the playlist is there. In that playlist, all videos are available in order. I will give link for that playlist in the description box. You can refer it. Okay, so thank you. We will meet in the next video. Okay, with a digital Chebyshev filter design using the bilinear transformation. Okay, so it is also a university question. We will discuss in next video. Okay, so thank you.